Hey there, folks. Amazing Atheist here. Responding to a video by a guy calling himself Hellbound Hellhound, or maybe Hellhound Hellbound. I don't remember precisely his name, the order of words, but it's a cool name at any rate. Anyway, he asked me a question. I'm not gonna restate the question. Just watch his fucking video, you lazy bastards. it's short. Here's the deal. I knew this kid back, I guess about a year or two back. This guy I encountered in my travels. I met a guy who was of moderate intelligence. Not moderate. He was of moderately above average intelligence, is what I mean to say. He was a fairly intelligent guy who believed himself to be the smartest man on the planet. And I don't mean in the sense that we all kind of believe ourselves to be the smartest person on the planet. I mean, he really believed he was the smartest person on the planet. And he acted accordingly in some respects. He was one of those people who believe that manipulating people, that controlling people, that finding ways to use his intellect for what really amounts to sadism, it is proof of his intellectual superiority to other people. And one of the things he used to do when he was in high school, every time one of his friends would fail a test or get rejected by a girl or not make the team or anything, any failure, whether it be social or scholastic, he took note of it, and the day of said failure, he would put a little red sticker on that person's locker without their knowing what he was doing. And I guess they would just come to the locker, see a little red sticker, be like, what the fuck? But not really make any sort of conscious association between this little red sticker and that day's failure. But the human mind is rigged to make associations, and eventually they began to associate the color red with failure. And he was very proud of himself. And who knows how successful it actually was, whether or not it was mostly in his own mind that he was really successfully doing this, or whether it really worked. So this story doesn't really show that people can be brainwashed, but it shows that there are people out there who will attempt to brainwash other people. Now, the question of whether or not such brainwashing actually works is up for debate. Although he perceived it as working, there's no real way you can really know if that worked, at least not on that scale. I'm sure there's a test that we could do, and there have probably been tests that have been done. If you know of any such tests, please link me up. I would love to read about them. But let's just assume, for the sake of argument, that they do work, okay? So let's say you see this Coke commercial, and they've got all the ingredients that make up a commercial on television. Usually the commercials on TV are usually funny or sexy. Those are the two things that American advertising agencies seem to focus on. And there might be a reinforcement of the status quo there, but you have to remember that that's why it's the status quo, okay? It's impossible for the majority of things in a culture to go against the status quo, because then that would be the status quo. So when you see these commercials reinforcing the way things are, that's not necessarily some intentional evil on the part of some maniacal corporate geniuses. That's just an arbitrary consequence. That's just a completely arbitrary consequence. And it's because they're plumbing these commercials from the depths of the zeitgeist of America. And they're going to reflect the status quo, and it's inevitable. You watch these commercials for herbal essences, and Coca-Cola, and Clearasil, and and Viagra and Burger King and Dr. Pepper and all that shit. And, you know, a Coke commercial is trying to get you to buy Coke. It doesn't really give a shit if you obey the government or not. If Coke did a poll, if Coke found that 80% of the population was against the government and that they hated the government and that was a passionate issue for them, you'd start seeing some anti-government Coke commercials, because all they give a shit about is selling fucking Coca-Cola. That's all Coca-Cola is interested in, is selling Coca-Cola. It's all Pantene Pro-V is interested in, is selling more Pantene Pro-V. That's all that fucking Tums is interested in, is selling more Tums. The government is interested in selling the government. No one else much gives a fuck. There's not money changing hands where the government's saying, well, you know, you just put some subliminal advertising in your commercials and we'll kick you back a cool mill. It's just not happening. So there's really no reason for it. And then if you have the government as it appears, or even remotely as it appears, then really they're not competent enough to brainwash us, and they're not single-minded enough to brainwash us. They're not clear enough on their agenda to brainwash us. They can't tell us, they can't try to control us and make us do what they want us to do if they don't even know what they want us to do. And it's pretty apparent that, for the most part, they just don't. So I hope that answers your question. I hope that clears up any kind of inconsistency you might have spotted. If not, let me know, and I'll elaborate further on whatever point you want me to. Amazing Atheist, peace the fuck out!